going on, y'all? Floyd Mayweather, Marcus Maidana tonight. It's finally here. All right, the rematch is up. Just wanted to give you my final thoughts of the fight. So I wanted to touch on one thing real quick. I think I brought it up in the prediction video. But and if you haven't seen that, please check that out because that's the full breakdown of the fight. Not enough people are discussing the fact that there's going to be a different referee this time. From what I saw in the first fight, Tony Weeks let them fight for the majority of the fight, okay? We know how rough Marcus Maidana gets. We know how dirty he can be. We know that Floyd Mayweather likes to use his elbows to create space. You know, Maidana has the low blows and the rabid punches. The referee can definitely disrupt Marcos Maidana's rhythm. If he does not like the rabid punches that Maidana has been allowed to do all of this time, he's going to keep stepping in every time he throws it, okay? Which is often, all right? He can start giving strict warnings for the low blows. If there's one low blow, he can give a warning. If there's another low blow, he can take a point right then and there, all right? Who knows if the ref is going to allow Maidana to smother Floyd like the way he was doing. All right, now Floyd, he does the elbows, but for the most part, he gets like a little, slight little warning here and there. Nothing major, you know. He doesn't get 2 points taken away from throwing using his elbows, all right? So I doubt that happens. But if the ref is a little bit more strict than Tony Weeks was, it can work against Maidana. All right, so I just wanted to bring that up because no one really has mentioned it. I haven't really seen anyone mention it like that. Now, the game plan for Maidana, according to him and Robert Garcia, is they want Maidana to come in lighter, okay? He's not going to gain 15, 20 pounds overnight like he usually does. He's not going to come in at 165. They're talking like 153, okay, for fight night. They want him to have less weight. They want him to be better conditioned to fight aggressively throughout the entire fight. Me personally, I doubt that he's going to be able to do that because he was fighting at a very, very high level, okay? And especially when you're getting punched, you're catching punches to the body like the ones Floyd was giving. I seriously doubt he's going to be able to fight for 12 rounds that way, okay? Another thing is, Alex Ariza is not part of their camp. Is he going to be better conditioned now that Alex Ariza is not going to be there? I mean, Ariza is very good at what he does, okay? I don't know if this is going to have a negative factor on Maidana. I don't know if he's going to be more tired early, okay? Maidana had Ariza when he fought Broner, all right? Maidana had Ariza when he fought Floyd, okay? Both really good performances, in my opinion. So that could be a factor as well. Now, as far as the fighters, I mean, basically, Maidana has to do what he did in the first half of the first fight, okay? Be aggressive. Be aggressive, but be smart about it a little bit. You know, pick your shots a little better. He exerted a lot of energy by throwing wild punches the whole fight, okay? If you're throwing 8-9 punches in a row and you're only landing one or two of them, you're burning a lot of energy, okay? When you're hitting air. If you're going to miss, I mean, you're going to miss. You're not going to always hit Floyd, but slow it down. Pick your shots a little bit better. You know, try to land something. Don't just hit air. Hit his arms. Hit his body. You know, don't just go headhunting the whole time because Floyd ducks so low and the only thing that's left for him to do is try to hit him with a rabbit punch. All right? So I think Maidana, what he needs to do this time is pick his shots a little bit better. And if you're going to miss, I mean, you're going to miss because Floyd is great defensively. It's hard to hit him flush and clean, but just pick your shots better. Don't burn so much energy just swinging and swinging. You can be aggressive. You can get him against the ropes. You can be in control, but don't be so wild, okay? Maidana is used to fighting that way, so I doubt we see any difference when it comes to that, all right? But you never know. I mean, if the guy has improved as a boxer, in my opinion, all right? The jab worked for him well. He used it to set up the offense. He needs to keep pumping that jab, all right? He was able to land that jab in the center of the ring at times, all right? What Floyd is much better at. He used it to push Floyd against the ropes. Keep throwing that jab out, okay? Other than that, he just has to fight aggressive. I mean, he's not going to outbox Floyd. So, me personally, his best chances of winning is by knocking Floyd out early, okay? I think he hurt Floyd. A lot of people didn't really notice, but he kind of hurt Floyd early in the fight. It wasn't major, but he did hurt Floyd a little bit. I saw Floyd kind of off balance on his feet a little bit early in the fight, all right? Shane Mosley hurt Floyd early, okay? Zab Judah hurt Floyd early, okay? We need Floyd, if he's going to try to knock out Floyd, well, if he wants to win this fight, in my opinion, I think his best chances are by knocking out Floyd early. So he does need to be aggressive, but he needs to apply smart pressure, all right? Floyd, on the other hand, the lateral movement is the key to this fight, all right? We know he fights well with the ropes. He's just going to have to split it in half this time. He's going to have to, at points, he's going to be on the ropes. Don't stare there for too long. Sometimes he was standing on the ropes for a full minute, okay? Spin out of there. Get out of there any way that you can. You know, throw a couple shots, body shots, counter him with a couple uppercuts, you know, push off, create some space before he attacks. Whatever he does that we normally see Floyd does, you know what? He's going to do, but don't stay there for so long, okay? This guy's going to try to out-wrestle you. He's going to throw a lot of punches, okay? Some of them will land. Don't stay on the ropes this as long. I don't think Floyd is going to do it. I think the fight is going to be in the center of the ring a lot more often than it was in the first fight. And I think Floyd needs to do that to win this time, clearly, all right? To check left hook, his best punch. You know, when Maidana is, you know, coming in, especially when he's using that jab and he's swinging wild, that chef left hook is Floyd's, one of Floyd's best punches. He needs to use that, all right? He needs to use it, especially when Maidana is coming in. He needs to counter Maidana with that punch. Other than that, I think the key factor in this fight, and I think Floyd is going to win the rematch, is the lateral movement, okay? I don't know how well-conditioned Maidana is going to be. I don't know if Floyd is going to be able to, like, I expect him to go to the body more, but, you know, I don't know if he's going to be able to hold off Maidana again. You know, Maidana mentally is coming into the fight on a good mental state. I think he thinks he won the first fight. He's very confident, you know. I mean, even with the loss, he looked like he was impressed and satisfied with his performance that night. He doesn't think Floyd is as good as everyone believes he is, okay? He's felt Floyd's power. He never was seriously hurt against Floyd. And I think he's very confident coming into this fight, all right? So I think that's going to be a key factor. I think that's why the fight. I think Maidana has a chance of winning, okay? I think he has a chance. Mayweather, I think, is just too skilled, right? But you never know. This is boxing, and could it be Floyd's first loss? Maybe, you know? Maybe it might be his first loss. You know, we'll see. But I think Maidana is very confident coming into this fight, okay? Mentally, I think he's prepared, and it should be a good fight again, all right? I don't really care too much for the undercard, but if you didn't see it, I did I wouldn't call it a prediction video. But I did a Miguel Vasquez, Mickey Bay video. That's the only other fight on the card that I really discussed. I didn't really think any of the others were really worth it. But anyway, yeah, those are my final thoughts. I hope everybody have a good night. You know, be having a safe night out there. You know, if you're going out to these fight parties and drinking, be careful if you're driving and everything. And I hope it's a good night of fights, all right? I'll see y'all in a post-fight video.